Hi, I'm Gavin Smith.
I'm Will Tamblyn.
And I'm Matthew Vecchio.
And we're from Voxon Photonics. Mm-hmm. So I've put together this short video, 37 use cases for a Voxon display.
Just 37.
You've only got about 4 seconds per clip, and we're going to see if we can describe what we're seeing.
Let's do it. Let's jump straight in.
Okay, I accept your challenge.
All right, straight off the bat, I recognize a cross-section, a two-dimensional cross-section of a skeleton, which I suspect is about to come 3D.
There it is.
4,000 images a second, all projected at the right time so that they form a truly volumetric 3D image that you can look at from any direction with any number of people, and you don't have to wear anything on your head.
So we have here an STL file that is actually quite clearly a watch, and our operating system here, so you can navigate files.
And just open up any 3D file type you like.
And here's an OBJ file. So this is like STL, but you can have color data in there as well.
And here we've got some molecule files, which are .molle files. You can download them.
Which one's that, Matt? Do you recognize it?
That's TNT, I would say.
Dynamite. And this is an elevation map that's streaming off a terrain server. We've added some little airplanes on there.
This is Derview, which is like Google Earth, but for the VX1.
You can see the bathymetry, which is the ocean floor.
This is an installation we made for a museum that shows pain pathways in the human body.
That's a Unity demo, space game.
Saving the universe. The skeleton again, but this shows you how easy it is to navigate through 3D data.
Some real-time capture as well.
We can stream that over the internet as well. And a lot of museums are putting the artifacts online and scanning them so you can download stuff.
Right.
So this is GraphCalc, which is visualizing mathematics. You can write in a formula and impress your friends.
And maths can be fun.
I love this game. It's by the people at CMU. It's a take on the traditional claw game, except instead of getting inanimate objects, you are actually grabbing dancing people.
This is a face tracker from Faceware, kind of camera tracking for your face.
And this is leap motion. So this is tracking the movement of a hand, and you can see the skeleton in the display.
This is a game called Voxatron by Lexa Loffel. It's a fully interactive and
sandbox editing game.
So with Voxatron, you can actually make your own games with it as well. A lot of fun. Here we are showing off Voxatron at Tokyo Game Show a few years ago.
This guy was very fast. And this is another game. This is a turn-based
turret shooter
written in C.
A lot of fun.
Baked shadows on caustic maps in 3D Studio.
Gets
scary
me every time.
Spider.
FBX animation.
I don't like that one much.
Shooting a laser into the display.
That's cheating a bit there. That's just a laser going through
this
image.
This is a transition from two dimensions into three dimensions, like some amazing MC Escher artwork.
So this is a gaming prototype, proof of concept. This is about spatial relationships. This one is about sword fighting. It was very realistic. It reminds me of my first sword fight, actually. here's another game.
Vaguely familiar looking.
Yeah, you probably played it in the arcades, or at least your parents did.
This is a game that everyone will recognize, one of the best games of all time.
That's right, it's Doom. No, sorry, Ken's Labyrinth.
Exploding.
Mind blown.
Exploding physics in Blender. I like Blender.
Lots more physics here. We've got some liquid physics in an animated engine.
This kind of looks like, this is a pre-COVID crowd simulation.
That's what crowds used to look like, ladies and gentlemen.
Lots of physics, lots of fluid simulations
here. More fluids. We love saturating the VX1 with fluid demos.
This is downloaded from the protein data bank. That was a protein.
And that's why you don't park your car in the swimming pool.
And this is using the translucency as an advantage to see in the model.
Volumetric capture from 40 views. This is,
pointing at point cloud data.
Very meta. I love it.
This is DICOM. This is one of our best formats, probably, in terms of detail. You can look at medical data. You can go inside it. You can measure it. You can do views that you can't do in any other display. Here we are looking directly down this human spine.
And this is us looking at the different densities of the tissue.
Segmentation in real time.
And this isn't DICOM data. This is an FBX animation of a human heart. This is DICOM data. This is a gravity map of South Australia.
And this is the new format from Microsoft for volumetric capture.
And here we have Gavin staring intently at the animation of an engine.
Lots of detail. And here's some more detail. This is an STL file showing just how much detail you can get. This little bug is 1/1,000,000,000th of the size of the big bug.
And that is a fuzzy donut.
A colorful example of hair follicles as well.
So quite a diverse range of different types of data there.
Yeah.
That was pretty fast.
We got through it.
Yeah, we did.
Digest.
We did all right. But we didn't stumble that much.
Hopefully it gives you a glimpse of some of the types of things you can do with a volumetric display for research, for visualization, for education.
And I suppose that really is just the things that we've come up with within the last short period of time. But I'd love to hear what you guys want to see on the display or want to put on there yourself.